I am Aditya, and I'm going to show you how we will assemble this electrochemical cell for chemical reduction of nitrates to ammonia. So we have this bottom part over here, which is essentially our electrochemical cell, where our electrodes and electrolyte will go in. And on top, we have this case for our solar panel, through which we'll insert our solar panel in, and then we'll connect it through the cell so that we can do the electrochemical reaction. So first off, we'll use this solar panel case and put this triple junction 32% efficient light absorber into it. Putting this on the side, we'll now assemble the electrodes. We have the oxide derived cobalt as our cathode and nickel foam as our anode. Now we'll be pouring in the electrolyte for this reaction, which is 1 molar potassium nitrate and 1 molar potassium hydroxide. Once the electrolyte is filled, we'll add 500 microliters of Messler's reagent, which will help us in detecting the presence of ammonia. Once all of this is done, we will assemble the solar case on top of the electrochemical cell. And that is our full setup.
Hi, I'm Nishita, and I'm gonna demonstrate how this device works. So this is our electrochemical cell, and this is our solar cell. So electrochemical cell has two different parts, two different electrodes, cathode and anode. So the cathode in our case is oxide derived cobalt, and the anode in our case is nickel foam. So what happens is, when we place this device, when we irradiate using sunlight, the electrons will be ejected from the solar cell based on the photoelectric effect, and the electrons will travel and reach the cathode based on this connection. So when we make it, when we connect it, the electrons will reach the oxide derived cobalt. And the electrons will cause the nitrates to reduce into ammonia. So it's an 8-electron process. So the nitrates will be reduced to ammonia on the surface of this cobalt. So there will be an electron depletion on the other side. So the water will react and form oxygen and electrons. So that electrons will travel and reach the other side of the solar cell, and the circuit is completed. So when the ammonia is formed, that will react with the Nestler's reagent, which is added to the electrolyte. So the Nestler's reagent is our indicator. So we could see the streamlines of ammonia, which is diffusing into the product, and it will be brownish in color once the ammonia is formed. So that's how this setup works.
Hello everyone. My name is Meenesh Singh from University of Illinois, Chicago. As you have seen how my students have discovered a reactor that can convert nitrate to produce ammonia using sunlight. You have seen how Aditya has shown the assembly of the reactor followed by its operation by Nishitan. I'm going to show you how this reactor operates in presence of sunlight. This is the reactor, and I'm going to now connect the terminal of this reactor to the solar panel. As soon as I connect it, you will see the reaction starting spontaneously. Now you can see the reaction has started, and you can see some brown color forming on the right hand side, which is ammonia. And it is producing as a streaks of ammonium ion produced in the solution. And quite instantaneously, in few minutes, you will see the entire solution will turn brown. You can see the potential of this technology can be revolutionary. It can take the nitrates from the wastewater stream and sunlight to produce ammonia for fertilizer application as well as to generate electricity. Thank you.